Food inflation remaining a top concern for Finance Secretary Ralph Recto as government looks at further monetary policy easing to boost the economy. Andrea Taguines reports.
More interest rate cuts are expected in the coming months, with Philippine inflation seen to stay within the government's target band of 2 to 4%. That's according to Finance Secretary Ralph Recto. Speaking at the Pilipinas Conference 2024 in Makati, Recto said further monetary policy easing is key to boosting the economy after the Philippines posted a lower GDP growth in the third quarter.
The challenge is to bring interest rates down so that we could have higher growth next year and in the coming years. And to be able to do that, you need to bring down inflation.
Inflation rose to 2.3% in October from 1.9% the previous month, but stayed within the forecast range of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas. Recto said the favorable domestic inflation outlook has already allowed the BSP to cut interest rates by 50 basis points in its last two policy-setting meetings. But he also acknowledged that food inflation in particular remains high.
So government is doing its best to ensure that we reduce, most especially, food inflation. We've reduced tariffs on rice.
Yes.
And hopefully by December to January next year, we will feel the full effects of the reduction in the rice tariffication.
For the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the depreciating value of the Philippine peso is also concerning, as it may lead to higher prices.
We're one of the biggest rice importer, okay? And that's, I'm linking that to the exchange rate. If the exchange rate is high, or vice versa, it's low, then our importation of rice would be high also, okay? And that would affect our inflation. Okay? I hope that would stabilize. There's talk about reducing our rates, interest rates. I hope that would not further weaken our currency.
Meanwhile, Barcelona believes the re-election of Donald Trump as U.S. president may bode well in terms of lowering the price of imported commodities should he work to ease geopolitical tensions such as the war between Russia and Ukraine, which has disrupted the global supply chain. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Shifting gears now, the province of Cagayan now free from bird flu. The Agriculture Department made that declaration after months of monitoring and disease control operations. Agriculture Secretary Francisco Tiu-Laurel also says latest surveillance activities yielded negative avian influenza results. The DA had placed the entire province under close monitoring after an H5N1 strain of the bird flu virus was detected in the town of Solana back in January of 2023. Now, before that, Cagayan has been free of bird flu due to disease control measures. An update now on the weather. Typhoon Marce continues to weaken as it moves over the sea west of Ilocos Norte. It carries maximum sustained winds of up to 155 kilometers per hour, with gusts reaching 215 kilometers per hour. Tropical cyclone wind signal number 4 remains in effect for the northwestern portion of mainland Cagayan and Apayao, as well as Ilocos Norte and Ilocos Sur. The typhoon is forecast to leave the Philippine area of responsibility later today, Friday. Before its expected exit, Marce left a trail of destruction in northern Luzon, especially in Cagayan, where it made landfall on Thursday. Now, over 4,000 families have been evacuated in the province. Several bridges are impassable because of flooding, with some communities left without power. Leaders in the construction industry working with the government to train and upskill more workers in the booming construction business. Jervis Manahan has the details.
Is a forum centered on innovation.
The Philippines is seeing a construction boom as demand for housing grows. To showcase the latest innovation in the construction industry, the Philippine Constructors Association, or PCA, has launched the PhilConstruct 2024. It is an exhibit participated by more than 1,000 exhibitors and attended by industry professionals, homeowners, and students alike.
Marami pong mga bagong technology ngayon, especially sa construction, to make cost-effective construction practices. Marami po tayong construction projects all around. Talagang pinupondahan po ng gobyerno yung ating infrastructure and yung mga climate resilience projects nandyan. And then maganda po yung demand sa ngayon nakikita nyo naman all over the place yung mga residential condominiums. And even yung mga houses po natin, marami pong nagpapatayo ng bahay.
More construction projects also mean additional job openings for skilled workers. At this end, the PCA says they are collaborating with the government to train or upskill more Filipinos to fill the industry's demands.
We would have more projects that are coming, and that would really help the industry. No? That's why we are preparing our people, training our people, training our skilled workers. No? And this is the key on how we can get bigger projects.
The group is also building libraries and hospitals for children as part of their corporate social responsibility. For this year, the PCA is partnering with KBYN and Kapamilya News anchor Noli De Castro to refurbish two houses of families in need. The exhibit is open to the public until Sunday, November 10. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Now, multilateral bank ADB greenlights $1.7 billion in financing for the construction of a climate-resilient expressway along the Philippines' largest lake. Under the Laguna Lakeshore Road Network project, ADB will fund the construction of a section of the 37.5-kilometer expressway. The project aims to provide a resilient road link within the Southern Manila Transport Corridor and reduce peak hour travel time between Taguig City and Metro Manila and Calamba City in Laguna by 25%. The project is also expected to benefit approximately 3.5 million people and improve access to markets and public services. The north-south corridor around the lake is crucial for local and international goods transit, accounting for nearly one-third of the nation's cargo back in 2021. Here's some reprieve for commuters. In the southern Metro Manila, five stations of the LRT1 Cavite Extension are set to open later this month. These include the Asia World and the Nino Aquino stations. Private operator Light Rail Manila Corporation said the new stations will extend LRT1's route by 6 kilometers, bringing the total to 26 km. The railway currently runs from FPJ Station in Quezon City to Baclaran Station in Pasay. The expansion is expected to increase ridership from 320,000 to 400,000. This number projected to rise to around 650,000 by the year 2028 or 2029. Phase 2 will open the Las Piñas and Zabota stations, while Phase 3 will include the Niog station in Bacoor, Cavite. The government has yet to announce the timeline for these stations. Still in infrastructure, the Philippine Transport Department planning to coordinate with the Philippine Coast Guard to deputize its personnel along the EDSA busway to prevent traffic violators from fleeing. This comes after an incident on November 3 when an SUV with a protocol plate 7 illegally passed through the busway and escaped. During a Senate Committee on Public Services hearing, Senator Rafi Tulfo suggested the move, emphasizing that violators may respect the authority of the PCG more because of its uniformed and armed personnel. Tulfo also questioned whether DOTR lacks motorcycle units to pursue violators. The senator proposed a memorandum of agreement between the DOTR, LTO, MMDA, and PCG to address the issue. Bad news for motorists, another major oil price hike looms next week. Diesel prices could go up by nearly 2 pesos, while gasoline and kerosene may see price increases of at least 1 peso and 10 centavos per liter.
Kung mapapansin nyo sa United States, parang hurricane season. Kung tagbagyo sa atin, sila din nagkakaroon ng unos. Naapektado yung Gulf of Mexico kung saan madai sila mga oil rig. Second, itong si OPEC Plus member countries, dinilay-nilay yung plano na mag-i-increase sila ng production by December. Itong Federal Reserve ulit ng United States, tinitignan nila na magkaroon ng panibagong interest rate cut.
Tech giant IBM calling for project management to pave the way for quantum computing. This as the firm sees a technology which leverages quantum mechanics to solve complex problems faster, much faster than traditional computers, as a solution to some of the biggest challenges across various industries.
Granted, right, we don't have a program management to look at cryptography, it's always vulnerability detected, patch that, right? And we think about log4j, SHA-1 to SHA-2, those are migrations that are well known, but even today, right, not 100% of these systems has been patched, right? So think about, you know, we really think about, you know, almost all of today's cryptography needs to be placed within the next, I don't know, decade or so. Think of quantum computing not as a faster CPU, not as a faster GPU. Think of it as a completely different paradigm of computing, where if you think about a mouse in a maze problem, right? In classical computing, the mouse will try to solve the maze problem one step at a time. But think of quantum computing as smoke propagating through the maze. So it goes through all corridors, above the corridors, all at the same time. So this parallelism provides an immense potential, right, to solve a lot of the most difficult problems that we have in the industry.
Health and beauty retailer Watsons opening its 8,000th store in Asia on Thursday, and that's here in Manila at a mall in Pasay City. The SM Group's C family attended the launch, vowing continued support for the brand as it plans to open more stores across the country. Covering 900 square meters, the new Watsons branch is one of a kind in the Philippines. It actually opened its first store in the country in partnership with SM Prime Holdings back in 2022. Since then, it has expanded to nearly 1,200 branches nationwide, providing jobs to over 10,000 Filipinos.